Hello students, in this chapter we are going to discuss briefly about the scheme of pharmacognostic study. For the detailed study of crude drug, there is an accepted scheme of pharmacognosy study which highlights on the following points. The first one is official titles or official names. These includes the pharmacopoeial names. In the globe, there are different pharmacopoeia which have their different names. So all these names can be included in this official title. Second point of the scheme is synonyms. It is also another name of crude drug which are widely used locally or commercially. It is also known to have vernacular name. And then third one is biological origin. So biological origin, it is nothing but the definition of crude drug. It includes the part of the plant which is used along with the botanical name and family. It also includes the minimum percent limit of the major active chemical constituents. The fourth point is geographical distribution and history. The history contains its utilization as a therapeutic purpose for the first time has been studied in history, along with how this plant has been recognized for therapeutic purposes. In the geographical distribution, the study is focusing on its native or indigenous places, along with its commercial cultivation places in the different parts of the world. The cultivation and collection, cultivation part focuses on a different parameters which affects the growth and propagation of a plant, such as the climatic conditions, temperature, rainfall, altitude, and other important parameters like fertilizers, pesticide, etc. The collection and harvesting includes the harvesting stage of the plants, the method of harvesting, along with the special care which is needed to be taken during the harvesting, and all the stages which are included for the packaging or preparation of the crude drug for market. In the microscopical characters or morphology, it includes the study of morphological feature of the plant, which will helps to identify the drug when it has been judged by its morphology. It includes the parameter like color, odor, taste, size, shape, along with the other distinguishing characteristics which we cannot categorize into this five characteristic. Microscopical characteristic of a crude drug or histology, it includes the study of histological characteristic. These characteristics are studied into two parameters or in two category, as a general characteristics and the distinguishing characteristic. Then chemical constituent point in the pharmacognostic scheme. So in this part, the therapeutically active chemical constituents are considered as the major phytochemical constituent, and their percentage has to be included into the chemical constituent, along with the other chemical constituents. We can say other similar type of chemical constituents are considered as a minor chemical constituent, and remaining are the other chemical constituents. So in the chemical constituent, these chemical constituents present in the plant are categorized into three categories, like major, minor, and other chemicals. Chemical test, it includes the special chemical test which is used for confirmation and identification of the crude drug. Therapeutic and pharmaceutical uses, in this part of the scheme, the therapeutic use of the crude drug are mentioned along with the pharmaceutical uses or applications and pharmacological claims. In the last but one part of the scheme, that is commercial varieties, substitutes, and adulterants. Commercial varieties means these are nothing but the varieties which is similar to that of the junine crude drugs and can be used commercially. So that is commercial varieties. Substituents means these are the other species of the plant which having a similar chemical constant. Adulterants means they only looks morphologically similar, but they are not chemically similar. So in this part, the The commercial varieties and substituents are mentioned along with the biological source and the chemical constituents and their percentage of active chemical constituents. And in case of adulterants, the biological source and distinguishing identification feature are being studied. In the last point, that is storage and preservation of crude drugs. Here we know that there are some crude drugs which need a special storage conditions and packaging conditions to protect from the deterioration. So for such kinds of plant, their storage and preservation has to be studied in the scheme of pharmacognostic study. The details of these pharmacognostic scheme along with the examples we mention in our book, textbook of pharmacognosy for diploma, you can refer it. Thank you.